Welcome to all of you on VPLSU Academy. My name is Ashish Garg and today we are going to learn the previous year questions of columns that is asked in the previous year of IAS examination and the GATE examination. From previous year, if you see, the one or two questions is being asked from the columns in 2 to 3 years. But it is relatively very easy topic as compared to other topics in the strength of material. You have to follow some formulas and then you can easily solve the question that is being asked from the columns. So starting with today's topic, columns. You know that the columns are the axial load carrying members. Axial load carrying members, but we have two theories here, Rankine theory and the Euler's theory, on the basis of which we calculate the load acting in the columns. So from Euler's theory, they generally ask you to find out the value of load that is acting in the column. So the value of crushing stress in case of this is given as pi square a by lambda square. That is our crushing stress value, or you can say crushing stress value or crushing load. If they ask if crushing load, then this is multiplied with area and this will give us pi square ei divided by L effective square. This is another formula that is for Euler's theory. Now the question asked here also is related to assumptions in case of Euler's theory. What are the various assumptions in Euler's theory? If I ask you the previous year question, they have given you in case of Euler's theory, this theory is valid for long columns. If first option is this, and second option is if this theory assumes the column is uniform. This theory assumes column is uniform. Column is uniform initially. Or whether this theory assumes bending stresses or bending load in column is less as compared to axial load. You have to tell which of these statements is correct. This is the question asked from the assumptions of Euler's theory. And similarly, they may ask you, what if the column is not initially straight or column is have certain bending initially? Does the Euler theory is valid there? What is the effect of initial bow on the load of the column? They may ask you also that if the beam is initially isotropic or beam is isotropic and uniform, does it actually affect the load on the column? So these are some kind of questions that is being asked from the assumptions of Euler's theory. And if I tell you the other question that is asked from here is, they may ask you to find the maximum slenderness ratio for which this theory is valid. Maximum slenderness ratio for which, or say minimum slenderness ratio for which this theory is valid. Now you can find out this by equating this to its yield stress. And from here you can calculate its lambda value. This value should be always less than the yield stress. So here you can get lambda should be greater than, or this will become again maximum. Lambda should be greater than, we know the relation of lambda with the strength of material. That is inversely proportional, or you can say stress of the material. Stress is the parameter of strength. Lambda and stress are inversely related, And from there also we can say if value of lambda is more, then the strength of the section will be less. This strength will be less, and from there we can calculate our maximum slenderness ratio. So this is the another kind of question that is asked from the column. Now they will, the another theory that I already told you is Rankine theory. From Rankine theory, what is the validity of Rankine theory? The question, first question asked is, Rankine theory is valid for, say, Rankine theory is valid for long column, intermediate column, or short column. They may ask you that. So it is actually valid for intermediate columns. So how do we calculate Rankine theory, and how, what is the Rankine load? If you calculate this, if PR is the Rankine load, this is given as FCA divided by 1 plus A times of lambda square. This may be A are also referred as alpha in some question. A is also referred as alpha in some question. This value of this is equal to FCR divided by pi square E. FCR divided by pi square E. Now the question that usually asked is, they will give you the value of alpha. They will tell you the crushing load or crushing stress here. They will give you the area of cross section of the column and the slenderness ratio. By giving you the effective length and the diameter of the section, you can calculate the slenderness ratio. From there, you can calculate your Rankine load. So this is the question that is usually being asked. Now the another question that is being asked from the column is, by changing its end condition. By changing its end condition, what is that? In case of end condition, they may say you, if we see this here, the question asked is, you have given this column which is pinned at the ends, pinned at the end, and having length L. Having length L, they will ask you to find out the effective length of this column. Effective length of this column. Similarly, if this spot is changed to fixed condition, or say this is fixed condition and this is your pin condition, then what is the effective length? Similarly, they will ask you if this is fixed condition and the above also is fixed condition, what is the effective length of this section? Once you calculate the effective length, then again they ask you to calculate the crushing stress, which is equal to pi square e by lambda square. In case of lambda, you will put its value and you will find out the value of crushing stress. So this is the question that is usually being asked many a time in the previous year from the columns. So this is quite very important. Now another question that is asked, they will give you something like this section. If this something section is given, then this is considered as, what is the effective length of this section? They will ask you to find out the effective length of this section, or they may ask you to find out the effective length if only we have this condition, that is free spot at the end. So this, once you calculate the effective length, you will able to calculate easily the crushing stress or crushing load. So these are the kind of question that is asked from the column. Now if we see the another dimension that is asked from the column is the kern of the section. What is the another dimension? That is kern. What is kern? Kern of the section, it is the region in which there is no tensile stress. In which there is no tensile stress in the section. Which means that the section have only compressive stresses. And they will ask you to find out that region. For example, in case of circle, if there is, say, bending is acting M, whose value is equals to P times E, and a load is acting, say, P, axial load P is acting over this section over this circular section, then they will ask you to find out its region where there is no tension in the section, and this can be calculated by equating the stress at the other end zero. If this is your value E, you put stress equals to zero at the another end, and you able to calculate E value equals to d by 8. Similarly, in case of rectangle, if this is your rectangle, they will ask you to find out the if this is P load, axial load acting, and the moment is acting, say PEX and PEY, if this is the P load and this is your EX and EY, this moment is acting now in the X direction and the Y direction. From here, they will ask you to find out the equation of the columns at any point, if they ask you to find out the stress at this point. If I show you in this in more valid way, let's say it more valid way, if this is your column, say this is your column, now a P load is acting here, say P load is acting here axially, P load is acting here, and this is its axis. If this is XX axis and this is YY axis, now here this load P is acting at certain eccentricity, that is equals to EX and EY, that is EY. Then the question is find the value of stress at any point in this column. Stress at any point over the cross section of the column. So this is the question that is asked. If someone asks you to find the value of stress at this point, say this is our point A. So stress at A point is being asked. This is the question that is usually being asked. From here, you know you have moment here on x-axis and you have moment here on the y-axis. If the ascent, you have given the value of i-axis, that is moment of inertia on xx direction and the moment of inertia on yy direction. These values are given to you. From here, you have to tell the value of stress at point A, or say stress at point here B, or say at this point C, or at this point D. So this is the another kind of question that is being asked in the previous year many a times. You can do this by taking the bending stress in this column. And if I tell you at point B, if this distance is your Y, capital Y, and this distance is your X, then the value can be written as sigma B, can be written as P by A plus PE times X, that will give us moment around y axis, that is P times EX divided by I by Y, and we take a round its X axis plus PEY divided by I by Y into Y. So this is the equation for calculating the stress at point B. If you calculate the stress at any other point, here we have seen that there is compression in the section, because moment is also acting like this in the X direction and the Y direction also. So it is compression for both MX and MY. But at this point, we have get compression for moment of X direction, but for Y we will get tension. So accordingly, you have to see whether you are getting compression in the section or the tension in the section, and from which you will be able to calculate the stresses at that point. So I hope you understand the kind of question that is asked in the previous year of columns. So this is the little overview of what are the different questions that is being asked from the columns. I hope you understand the
type of question that is being asked from the column. So have a nice day. Thank you for watching this video.